Assalamu alaikum developers. Today we are going to talk about view flippers. We are going to create some views in it and we will create two buttons for previous and next view. So let's get started. First of all, we will open a simple project in Android Studio. I will minimize this. We'll go to activity-main.xml and here, as usual, we will just move this constraint layout and change it to relative layout. Next, we will remove this text view from here. Next, we will create a view flipper here whose width will be match parent and height will also be match parent. Next, we will create a view flipper here whose width will be match parent and height will also be match parent. Next, I will give ID to this view flipper and it will be view_flipper. Now inside our view flipper, I will add a calendar view whose width will be wrap content and height will also be wrap content. Next, I will write here layout gravity center. Further, I will add a button to my view flipper whose width will be match parent and height will be 50 dp. I will write here the text my button and I will give the text size 20 sp. Further, I will add an image view here whose width will be wrap content and height will also be wrap content. And for source, we will be using the already present image inside Android Studio and that is admin map/ic_launcher. Lastly, you can also include a text view here. Now in all these cases, I will add here layout gravity and set it to center. So we are done with our XML file. We'll go to activity-main.java and here we will write view flipper. Next, inside our onCreate function, I will write mViewFlipper is equal to findViewById r.id.view_flipper. Next, I want to set the interval for our view flipper. So I will write here the time in milliseconds. I will be writing here 2000, which actually means 2 seconds. And next, I will write here mViewFlipper.startFlipping. Now, one thing that I am missing here is adding the animation. So we'll go to activity-main.xml file and here inside the view flipper tag, I will write here in animation and we will select fade in. Similarly, we will write here out animation and we will select fade out. Now let's run our application and test it. Now we can see here that our application has launched and each view is fading in and fading out after 2 seconds. Next, we will be adding two buttons for next and previous view. So let's go back to our activity-main.xml file and where our view flipper tag is ending, we will write here button whose width will be wrap content and height will also be wrap content. Next, I will write here the text that will be next. Next, I want my this button to be present right here. So for that purpose, I will write here. Layout parent bottom true and next I will write here parent right true and further we will be giving it margin of 10 dp. Now you can see here that we have placed our button right where we want it. Next, we will give the ID to our button and it will be next_button. I will just copy this button now and paste it here. I will change the text here and we will write here previous. Similarly, I will just remove this line of code from here and we will change the ID of our button and it will now be previous button. So now you can see that we are done adding two buttons. Now we'll go to activity-main.java. Here, first of all, we will initialize our buttons. So we'll write here button next_button, comma previous_button. You just have to press Alt and Enter and it will include the library for button. Next, inside our onCreate function, I will write here next button is equal to find UIID, r.id, dot next button, and similarly I will write here previous button is equal to find UIID, r.id, dot previous button. Next, we want the animation to be dependent on these buttons. So I will just move these lines of code and we will write here next button dot set on click listener new view dot on click listener, and inside the on click function we will write here m view flipper dot show next, and similarly for our previous button I will write here set on click listener new view dot on click listener, and inside the on click function I will write here mview flipper dot show previous. Now let's again run our application and test it. Now you can see here that our application has launched, and when we will press the next button we will have the next view, and similarly when we will press the previous button we will have the previous view. Now one thing that you can see here that when I am pressing the next button it is just repeating things after again, meaning my text view should be the last view and it should not show me the next view from here, but when I press the next button it again shows me the calendar view. So how to change that? For that purpose we will go to mainActivity.java. Here I will write an integer and it will be my count. I will initialize it to 1. Inside our onCreate function I will write here mViewFlipper dot, it is giving me an integer value, so I will write here int child count. Alright, so inside our next button onClick function I will write here my count is less than child count, so it should show us the next view, and similarly we will increment my count by 1. And inside our previous button onClick function I will write here if my count is not equal to 1, which means that we are not on our first view, then in that case I want it to show the previous view, but in the other case I want it to generate a toast. The toast will show that no more previous views. Similarly, we will copy this line of code from here and paste it inside our next button on click function, and we will change here previous to next. One thing that I have left here is that I will decrement my count inside my previous button on click function, so that each time my button is being pressed I would be able to know that which view is actually being shown, meaning which child is being shown right now. So now let's run our application and test it. Now we can see here that when we press the previous button it shows a toast no more previous views, and similarly if we go to our last view and then press the next button it shows us no more next views. So this is it for this tutorial. If this video has helped you even a little bit, then kindly subscribe to the channel and like this video.